Good morning, dear friends. Today we are going to learn about nouns and its division. So we are going to do the chapter. First, noun. If you remember the videos that I had sent you on your WhatsApp, you might have learned the definition of noun. So what is the definition of noun is? Noun is a name of person, place, animal, things, quality, and emotions. Okay? So, can you imagine a thing in the world which does not have a name? Everything in the world has got a name. Right? So that's why noun is one of the most important chapter in English, because here we learn to develop our vocabulary. So what is the definition of noun? Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, things, quality, and emotion. We also have learned the various types of nouns. So let us understand them by learning. Types of nouns. If you remember, the first noun is proper noun. Now what is proper noun? Proper noun is Bombay, Rajesh. Correct? So these are the nouns which are proper noun. You can see here the first letter of this noun is in capital. So when the first letter of this noun is in capital, that becomes a proper noun. Correct? It is a name given to a particular place or a person. The second noun we have learned is common noun. Now what is common noun? Common noun is nothing but the name which is given to a proper noun. In order to make it a common noun, we can say that Bombay is a city. So this city has become a common noun. It could be any city when we are talking. Correct? Rajesh. So we know it is boy. So when we talk about a boy, we are talking about any common. Correct? I want five boys. When we make it plural, that is the difference too. But in order to make a proper noun into common, we can say it is a boy. Correct? Boy becomes a common noun. The third one is collective noun. Now what is collective noun? Collective noun means that when you put this common noun into a group, correct? So that group becomes, or that group has a particular noun. Let us take this word boy, correct? If there are so many boys sitting in the class, so what I say is a group of boys. In order to understand, let us take one more example is that we can say an army of soldiers. Now when we say soldier, becomes one. Correct? Here in this common noun, soldier has become a, but when I want to give a name to a group of soldiers, then I say an army of soldiers. Another example we can say that a team of players. So this also becomes a collective noun. Name given to a group of things or group of persons. Fourth, we can see that is concrete noun. Now what is concrete noun? Okay, in order to understand concrete noun, we need to remember that concrete nouns are the things that we can see, we can feel, we can touch. Okay, so concrete noun that we can see, we can feel, we can touch. For example, duster. Can you see this duster? Yes, it's a concrete noun. Fill. Correct? We can fill also and we can touch also. So this is the perfect example of concrete bound. And the last one is abstract noun. Now what is abstract noun? So the abstract noun is the thing that you cannot see, touch or feel. These nouns we cannot see, we cannot touch, and we cannot feel. That is called the abstract noun. For example, friendship. So, can someone show me the friendship? Sir, this is friendship. No, we cannot show it, but we can understand. Correct? So, the word is like friendship. We can understand the word friendship. If you take the other example, brave. He is a brave boy. Correct? Don't get confused with the adjective. Correct? If you get confused with the adjective, then it will be a problem. So, bravery. Correct? So, bravery. Can you show the bravery? We cannot show the bravery. Correct? So, he is a brave boy, but his bravery is very, he is very strong. Correct? So, bravery we cannot show it to the person. Or advice. Correct? When we give someone advice, can you show the advice? No, we cannot show the advice. Correct? So these are the five things that we have learned in the first video. So what is the definition? Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, things, quality and emotions. In that we have learned types of nouns. There are five types of noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, concrete noun and abstract noun. Have you understood? Good. Now let us learn the second chapter, again, singular and plural. We have already learned about noun, correct? This is a similar chapter where we are going to learn about singular and plural. Most of the nouns are that in the first chapter we have done is about singular. Correct? Example, boy, boys. Girl, girls. So, let us see. Boy becomes boys. This is singular. And this is plural. So, singular and plural is very easy, but you need to understand there are few rules in order to understand this chapter. Correct? So, let us understand this chapter by learning some rules. Let us see the first rule is that by adding S. So, most of the nouns becomes singular nouns become plural by adding S. Example, boy, boys. Book, books. Girl, girls. Spoon, spoons. Correct? So we can see here singular and plural. So by adding S to the singular noun, correct, we get the plural form of that noun. It is one of the simple rule that we have. Correct? The second rule is that when a noun ends with, correct? When a noun ends with a singular noun ends with by adding S to the SSCH, SSZ or X, we get the nouns which are plural by adding ES. And in order to understand quiz, it becomes quizzes. Have you understood? It's very simple. Correct? When the noun ends with SS, SCH, SHZ or X, we have to add ES. Correct? Let us learn the third noun.
Legs.
L-I-V-E-S. Wives becomes wives. These are the two short examples that we have given. But understand, when a noun, singular noun ends with F or F-E, we have to add V-E-S. So we have to take out this F. Correct? And we have to add V-E-S in order to make plural noun of that form. Understood? Good. So these are the simple rules about the singular and plural noun. Thank you.